YouTube family, what is going on? Welcome back. If you clicked on this video, you probably want more information about chlamydia symptoms in men specifically. Well, I have some good news and I have some bad news, unfortunately. The good news is I'm gonna answer that question in detail. The bad news is chlamydia can cause a diverse set of symptoms, and you'll actually be very surprised on the different conditions a man could develop due to chlamydia trachomatis. With that being said, let's dive in. If you have time today and you like my content, or if you like this video and you want to support my channel, please like and subscribe below. If you're watching this video and you're having symptoms or you're just concerned, don't be ashamed. Chlamydia is the most common bacterial sexually transmitted disease a man or woman can develop. So sometimes things just happen. Also, it's very important to stay throughout the video because I'm gonna be talking about all the conditions a man could develop due to chlamydia trachomatis. So down the line, if you have a potential symptom, a light should turn on and think, do I have chlamydia trachomatis? Finally, getting into chlamydia trachomatis. Chlamydia trachomatis has an incubation period of around 5 to 14 days. But what does that really mean? That means that if you have intercourse with somebody who's positive for chlamydia trachomatis, it will take around 5 to 14 days for somebody to develop symptoms, if they develop symptoms at all. When it comes to the most common condition a young buck could develop due to chlamydia trachomatis, it's urethritis. Urethritis is the inflammation and infection of the urethra. Remember, the urethra is that tube that takes urine from the bladder to the outside of the body. Symptoms a man can develop with urethritis is pain with urination, which is pain when you're peeing. They could also have a little bit of mucusy or clear discharge coming from the penis. If it's white and thick, that's more so associated with gonorrhea. A lot of times it's such a little amount that a man could have that they have to milk a little bit out of the tip of the penis, which is kind of weird. But honestly, the people that do have discharge usually just notice it in their underwear. Lastly, someone with urethritis may not have any symptoms at all and ultimately continue to pass the infection on to another person. The next condition is incredibly important. Chlamydia can cause infection of the epididymis, and that's called epididymitis. The epididymis is that structure behind each testicle. It transports sperm from the testicle to the vas deferens and gets released when you have intercourse. Fun fact, the epididymis can be as long as 20 feet. Imagine that. All that tubing behind each testicle, and it takes around 2 weeks for sperm to get from one side to the other. The reason why it's so long is because the sperm needs all that time to mature enough to fertilize the female egg. So the most important thing you need to know about epididymitis is the symptoms, and they include pain with urination, pain with ejaculation. You can develop pain and swelling on the back side of the testicle. You could also have blood in the urine. And an uncommon symptom is abdominal pain and lymph node swelling in the inguinal area. Next condition a man can develop is proctitis. Proctitis is inflammation and infection of the rectum. And the question is, what is the rectum? Where is it located? The rectum is the very end aspect of the colon. That's where stool collects prior to going through the anus and exiting the body. Proctitis is most commonly seen in men who have sex with other men. That makes sense, right? So chlamydia infects the rectum, ultimately causing symptoms. And these symptoms can include anorectal pain, which is pain in the butthole region, rectal bleeding, rectal discharge, and also men could have this weird feeling in the rectum where they always have to have a bowel movement. If you're interested in a more detailed video about chlamydia, check out my other video on chlamydia right up there. These symptoms are incredibly important to remember. Although the ones that we talked about previously are more common, these still can develop in men, and you definitely want to take notes and remember them for future reference. These issues can include conjunctivitis, reactive arthritis, and pharyngitis. Conjunctivitis is inflammation and infection of the conjunctiva, which is the white portion of the eye. Now, when you have symptoms of conjunctivitis due to chlamydia, somebody can have redness, swelling, and sometimes bumpy appearance on the eye. Now, there's only one way of getting that on the eye, and somebody has to get exposed to chlamydia through contact. So I'll let you use your imagination on how that can happen. Next is reactive arthritis, and this can be absolutely awful. This occurs from an untreated sexually transmitted disease like chlamydia. What happens with reactive arthritis is people can develop symptoms of arthritis throughout the body or sometimes just in a few joints. They can also develop uveitis or conjunctivitis around the same time. This is a great example why, if somebody does have chlamydia, they need to make sure they get treated to prevent something like this from occurring. Pharyngitis is the last one we're gonna talk about today. And pharyngitis is inflammation and infection of the actual throat. This can be caused by several different reasons. Viruses, bacterias, fungi can sometimes do it. But again, bacteria, chlamydia. So, chlamydia can cause pharyngitis, although this is pretty rare. How you get pharyngitis from chlamydia is through oral intercourse from an infected partner. A lot of times, people just complain of a little bit of sore throat, but to be honest, people just have a sore throat and it goes away on its own without treatment most of the time. Ultimately, folks, I really want to reiterate to you that men can be asymptomatic. So especially if you're with a lot of partners, make sure you're using condoms and other safe sex practices. Also, if you're in a monogamous relationship, it's always a good idea, especially if you're going to be with this person for a long time, to get a good STD check to make sure that both of you guys are safe and good to go. And that way you can have unprotected intercourse and not be concerned. On the other hand, make sure if you're not trying to have kids, use the appropriate birth control. I really do hope this video helped you out a lot. If it did, please like and subscribe below. That wraps up today's video on symptoms of chlamydia in men. Until next time, take care.